As social selling grows and becomes integrated into the sales process, the obvious questions are about metrics. Sales is used to measure everything, and social is no different. So what are some of the additional metrics you can measure? We can measure things like new social media followers and subscribers, new leads from social, new opportunities from social, closed sales from social, and total revenue from social. All of these metrics can be easily measured in Salesforce reporting. Reports are really an essential feature of Salesforce, and Salesforce has created a lot of options for you to review. So let's take a look at that now. So let's go to the reports area. You'll see that in this area, Salesforce has already created some of the most commonly viewed reports for you. There are opportunity reports, sales reports, lead reports. Salesforce does a good job of creating many of the most frequently used reports. So let's take a look at opportunity reports. We'll just click here. And I want to identify which of our opportunities came from social. So you'll see these are all of the different reports that Salesforce has come up with. And in my experience, it's always easier to edit an already created report than to create one from scratch. So here's a great one, opportunity sources. What sources are my opportunities coming from? So I'm going to click on that. And you'll see we have some information to customize that here. So we can look at the close date. We can look at the current full year or full quarter. I'm going to change this to the current and previous full year. And you'll see you have a lot of options here. And then it shows all opportunities. I'm just going to look at closed opportunities and I'll run the report. Now you'll see I get a quick summary here and it shows 4 records are not attributed to a lead source. We can actually change that if we wanted to, if we talked to our Salesforce admin and made it required to add that. That's fairly simple to change. We have web, phone. We have 2 leads that came from social, which is great. Now, if we want to see the detail here, we just go up to show details and we'll see a lot more information here. Now, this is great. These reports are also highly customizable. So if I hit on the customize button, this brings up a drag and drop screen. So I can look at a few different things. So I have a lot of columns here and scroll down and I can take these and I can remove columns, for example, if I want to. And then I can add columns. So if I want to look at expected revenue, for example, I simply hold that down and bring it over and drag it and that shows up. So I have some great information here. I'm going to save this report now. I'm going to go up here to the save button. And I can put a report description in here. And the great thing is that I can save this a few ways. So first, I can save it in my personal custom reports. That means only I will see it. It's my personal folder. I can also save it in unfiled public reports, which means everyone will have access to it. If I want to share the report or if I'm creating it for someone else, I can put it in there. And then Salesforce does allow you to create folders that are only available to specific people in Salesforce. So I previously created one for a California team, and that folder is only available to people who I've assigned access to. So right now I'm going to save it in personal custom reports. And you'll see that's saved now, and I can still edit it if I need to, or I can close it. It always gives you a nice reminder, which is helpful. And then you'll see it shows up right here.